All right, guys, so we're gonna do a trout today. I got the bill taped up. I scuffed it up a little bit with some Scotch-Brite. So I'm gonna mix a little bit of opaque. About 4 drops, 5 drops. A couple drops of reducer. Mix that up real quick. Couple light coats. Heat dry this, clean out my brush, and move to the next color. Alright, so the next color I'm going to do is I'm going to mix up my own pink. I'm going to run it right down the lateral line. So I'm going to start off with a little pearl red and my pearl white and a little bit of reducer. Red is really strong, so I'm not even going to need a full drop. I'm looking for. Pressure a little bit. Thank you. So I'm gonna heat dry this. All right, next color I'm gonna add is pearl green to the top. I like it. I'm gonna air dry it. All right, so you can see it's got a really pearl color to it. Really pretty right now, but I'm gonna change that. I'm gonna make it look realistic. So the key to making it look realistic is sepia. Stay away from the white and just put a really light coat to dull out some of the pearl. Then some dots on it, some little spots. I haven't decided if I'm going to use the back of the paintbrush or a toothbrush to splatter it. Let's see. So now we'll watch the sepia magic. See, it's all dulled out. Dots are next. All right, last step in the paint process. So what I'm going to do now my lure. One drop of ink, or paint, I'm sorry. That's it, let's dry it and throw some eyes on it and do some epoxy. So I decided black eyes with a little silver around it. Like I said in other videos, some people go with the crazy glue, some people don't. I don't really use it to hold the eye on, I use it to be able to move the eye around once I go to put it on. Eyes are on, we let it dry a little bit, and then put some epoxy on it. Stay tuned for the final step. So here I got a little paper cup, cut the bottom out. Two-part epoxy. one of the reasons I'd love to do this. Get away from the wife and kids for a little bit. Then again, my kids are pretty old. One's 21 and the other one's 26, but like most kids now, they just don't move out yet. Now this trout pattern is really good. I live in the Midwest in Illinois, so this trout pattern is really good this spring because they stock up all the ponds with trout. And then the pattern is really good in the fall if you put it on a deep diver or a lipless and you fish Lake Michigan, because all the big salmon come in to spawn. So this pattern plays out twice a year in the Midwest here. Somebody tell me about my insurance, my warranty on my car, some BS. Alright, that's it. Drip wire in the back. Hook in the front. I'd fish that all day and twice on Sunday. We'll get some pictures of it tomorrow when it's done drying and finish up the video. You guys, thanks for watching. Hit the like, the subscribe. Big shout out to Ugly Dog Lures. Without them, I don't think I'd be doing what I'm doing right now. He's taught me a lot of stuff along the way. So, all right, stay tuned, guys. Thank you.